Would you be so kind to tell us more about your first steps in agriculture? So how did you start? Was it at the University of Ghana, where is your start line, or was it earlier?
So for me, agriculture was earlier, but it wasn't really the study of it. So my dad is in the military, and every time we are moved into our accommodation, we always have a huge land around us. So my dad loves farming. He's always going out there and planting something, and so does my mom. So at that stage, we're introduced to agriculture. So we're farming. When you come back from school, you go and farm. But I really didn't think of it as a course I wanted to study in the university. I mean, I was just a young girl growing up. At a point in time, we even had a poultry farm where we were taking care of birds, and we were probably into egg production. And I did that for like a year before I went into the university. As at the time I was going into the university, I studied science in the senior high school level. But I think it was more of my parents coercing me into studying science, because I loved science, but I wanted to do something different, probably arts. So when I finished senior high school, I was like, oh, now I'm going to do arts. And my dad is like, no, I think a better idea for you, or a better choice would be for you to study agriculture. And I think that is where the study of agriculture started for me in the university. That's 2006, yes, 2006. That's when I started studying agriculture bachelor's. So I did my bachelor's in agriculture at the University of Ghana. I also did my master's over there at the University of Ghana. And currently I'm a doctoral researcher also in the University of Ghana, but with the West Africa Center for Crop Improvement. So for me, that has been my journey with science, with agriculture. And it's not a journey I regret. I really have loved the impact that I am hoping I'm making now, and I'm hoping to make even as I advance in my career. So I really think that this is a good, one of the best decisions I made was actually listen to my dad and study agriculture. So that's my journey in agriculture.
Mm-hmm. And also, as I understand now, you are a PhD researcher, yes? So you are doing your PhD research, and you are focusing on corn breeding. Is it correct?
Yes, you
and,
are right.
Why have you chosen exactly this crop?
Okay, so ever since my whole study of agriculture started, I've been in the cereals industry. So my first cereal was sorghum. I worked on sorghum. For my undergraduate level, I was looking at carotenoids in sorghum. So I did that. And then in my master's level, I got introduced to corn. By then, in my mind, I only knew corn as a crop that was very much consumed in the country and was a major component of our dishes. I didn't really understand the science and the biology of crop breeding. But when I got introduced to it, I really loved it, because especially because as a crop, it's very easy to develop hybrids from corn comparatively to other crops. It's not a difficult crop to work with. For my PhD, I actually decided to stay in maize, because corn in my country, Ghana, corn is the most consumed and most produced crop in the country. And I wanted to be able to work on a crop that I could contribute to the livelihoods of farmers in communities. Most smallholder farmers in the country cultivate corn. And in fact, almost everybody during the rainy season is planting corn. In Ghana, we have two seasons. That's the major rainy season and then the minor. Mm-hmm. That's for the southern part. But in the northern part of Ghana, if not for climate change, we would have just one season of rainfall, which would last for about 3 months, and then that would be the end. So I really wanted to work on the crop and see how I could contribute through varietal development to impact the lives of farmers who grow this crop. Not only are they growing it, but they are also feeding into the value chain, and I wanted to be able to contribute to that as well. Hence my crop of choice, hence the reason why I've stayed in working with maize. And it's an interesting crop to work with. It's one of the crops that globally has been worked on and has served as a template, especially in genetics for other crops as well. So it's been an interesting journey so far working with maize. I've been with maize for almost 8 years now.
Oh, wow. My master's 8 years is quite a lot, yeah.
Yes, through to this time. So, yeah, that's the reason why I chose to work on home.
Mawulawoe, and what about the challenges which you met, which you have met during the period of work at the West Africa Center for Crop Improvement? What maybe it's professional challenges or any other challenges which you have?
Well, I think that professionally, sometimes navigating through this space as a woman is it can be a challenge for me. It's a space where you find more men than women. And we should understand that gender plays a role in the decisions that we make. And a lot of times, who you are influences how you handle issues. And it is easier when you can talk to a fellow woman about any challenge that you're facing than talking to a man. So for me, I haven't really faced major challenges working at the West Africa Center for Crop Improvement, because that institution is run by a director that believes in the inclusion of women. So he always, all the time, is empowering us as women to rise up and take up the challenge of being in the ag space. So personally, I haven't faced major challenges. Maybe for me, it is having to manage my work with WAKI and also my passion working with women. That's with the NGO. Balancing that and being able to fulfill my role as a mother. That probably is a dynamic challenge for me because of the various activities I'm involved with. But with the center professionally, I think it's been a good ground for me to develop as a woman. And I look outside and I see other departments that don't have such environment, such culture that allow women to have an opinion, that allow women to rise up, that allow women to go out there and be better, especially as scientists.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a very good opportunity at WAKI to be influenced and also influence.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that for me, my only challenge has been probably as a person, how to balance my role, being a worker, being a student, being a mother, and also having to also contribute to the in the NGO space. That will probably be the challenge I face, how to be able to be productive. Yeah.
Yes, it's absolutely true that so many women are struggling with juggling with all these roles which you have in your hands, and you still need to be good in all of these roles. And yeah, so I understand what you mean. But this is probably the start of the story for Network of Women in Growth, yes? Yeah, so now it's a very interesting time, because I'm sure this network will be useful for other women who are watching us. So please tell us about this network and how did you join and what are you doing over there?
Okay, so the Network of Women in Growth was actually founded by my mother.
Yeah, oh, my wow.
Yes, so she started the organization, and she started it 20 years ago. And it was born from a passion of where she saw that a lot of women who are marginalized and from vulnerable communities were not able to have access to requisite skills that they needed to be economically empowered.
Mm-hmm.
Through that, she decided to start an organization where she would train women to gain skills, especially in the vocational sector, for them to be able to have income-generating activities on their own. So that was how the organization started 20 years ago. I was a little girl then who didn't know what was happening. All I saw was every day there was one group of women coming into our home and leaving, and my mother...
You had very interesting childhood, you know. You have very busy childhood, I see.
Yeah, you would see a group of women coming and my mother is training them and they are leaving. And another group of women are coming, they are staying in our home, they are being trained, and my mom is going for, and by then, you know, we had started the whole gender advocacy in the country. There was a whole lot of talk about women empowerment, feminism, women's rights, accessibility. So all those things And most of these programs, when I was old enough, my mom would just carry me along that I should go and get to understand the gender space. Mm-hmm. So over the years, I've had to, she had to move into another role now, and I had to take over from her to run the organization on a part-time basis. So basically, as an organization, what we do is that we, through donor support, we are able to train women in vocational skills. Mm-hmm. Currently, our focus is enhancing or increasing the participation of women in male-dominated trade areas, because we have realized that, especially in certain careers, the women numbers over there are quite low. You talked about agriculture, you talked about science, and in other sectors such as the building construction sector, there are so many sectors we can talk about that is dominated by men, and only few women are in that sector. This is usually due to stereotypical norms, traditional beliefs, entrenched traditional beliefs, our cultural beliefs, and also sometimes even the young women do not feel, they don't fit, their capacity is not built for them to be confident mm-hmm. enough to believe themselves that they can do these things. So our organization, through donor support, is able to facilitate, is able to recruit and facilitate the training of such women to be able to provide them with skills for them to take up these trade areas such as plumbing, air conditioning and refrigeration repairs and installation. We train women in general electric cars. So basically, we are looking at increasing and enhancing their performance in these trade areas. Mm-hmm. So our organization is basically about that. We also do a lot of advocacy, trying to increase women and trying to advise more women to take up leadership roles in their communities and even in governance. This we do a lot through advocacy and engagement with the women that we work with in various communities in Ghana. Mm-hmm. So that is what we do at the Network of Women in Growth. It's just an organization that wants to do more for women. Our limitation sometimes is access to funding, but mm-hmm. we still try to do our best to so go out there and look for funding to be able to do the things that we do, especially because we are a grassroots organization. We're mm-hmm. not a big organization like that. So that's just
about Mawulawoe, and the following question is about the how a woman can join your organization if she want to have this training. What does she need to do? Does she need to contact you or go to website, or what she need to do? Tell us, please.
So usually for women who are interested in any of our trainings, especially for those that are donor funded, we normally send a call out mm-hmm. so that for those who are interested, they would apply, they will be interviewed, and they will be selected. Mm-hmm. Sometimes there are women out there who just want to be trained in certain vocational areas. They can also approach me or approach the organization and let us know. We may not have funding lying down or sitting down to support them, but because we are passionate about women's economic empowerment, we are able to support these women with free training so that they will gain the skills to be able to be economically empowered. Mm-hmm. And with that, it will help their activities and give them access to economic justice. So for anybody in Ghana that is interested not only with gaining skills, but even in partnership, in doing the things that we do, they can always contact me. We also have social media platforms on Instagram, on LinkedIn, on Facebook. Mm-hmm. They can always drop a message and we would respond and try to do the very best that we can to support them.
Okay, thank you so much. And probably it's also a very relevant question for you because you are active in all the social media. So do you have any interesting woman profile who are you are following, and maybe you recommend other women to follow? They maybe inspire you and share some interesting thoughts.
So I have a lot of women that
I can imagine you probably more than men. Yeah.
I think for me, there's one woman I follow on LinkedIn. Her name is Anita Eskin. Okay. She's a Ghanaian. Uh-huh. I read a post and it really inspires me. But for me personally, my greatest inspiration has come from my mother.
Oh, yeah, I can imagine. If she is a founder of such nice network, which you are participate and carry on her mission, yes, your mother is. So what is the name of your mother?
So she, her name is Mawulawoe Awity.
Okay.
So that's her name. And she's also on LinkedIn.
Oh,
so
nice.
She has been a great inspiration for me because I see her resilience. And I'm like, if she can do it, then I can probably outdo her. So my mission is to outdo her.
Yes, it's nice. You know, there is a proverb like the pupil is good if the pupil has did better than the teacher. So if your teacher does great job, this means that the pupil must be higher and better and faster than the teacher. So yeah, you are doing the right thing. Okay, Mawulawoe, so we will definitely find the link to the ladies which you mentioned, and we will follow them as well to see their messages and to read about them more. But my question is also, it's a traditional question actually for all our guests about books. So maybe you have a book or books which help you to keep the right mindset and empower yourself.
Okay, so there's one book that I've read. In fact, I've read it twice.
Oh,
that
wow.
Has been a mind. The first time I was given this book, I was, that was about 10 years ago. It was given to me by a friend to read. And then the second time was some few months ago. And the title of the book is Who Moved My Cheese?
Who Moved My Cheese?
Oh, you should. It is a very, very good book. And it's a book that I say it is a book you need for life because it just talks about our mindset when it comes to change, what we do, how do we react to change. And it's a very good book. And I've read it. And every time I read it, I learn something new. How do you adapt to change? Do you sit and wait for change to happen to you unexpectedly and with fear, you are scurrying around trying to find a way out, or you are even you are stagnated by fear, or are you always on the lookout to actually watch out for that change and be prepared for it? So it's been a book that I've read, and I would always recommend to people to read. Sometimes it's hard to keep up with reading, especially because of the activities I do, but I always try to read books that are more about that motivates me and empower me. And I think one good author to follow is John Maxwell. He's also a very good writer. His books are quite very good. So those are the kind of books I read. But I would recommend, it's a very small book, Who Moved My Cheese? Very small.
Okay.
But it's a book that has really been impactful in my life. And it's a book I would always read over and over again because every time I read it, I learn something new.
Okay. Thank you so much. So thank you so much for your thoughts and your inspiration, your advice to women who are not just only from Ghana, but from all around the world, because you said quite a lot of wise things, which are relevant to many of us. And I wish you good luck with your PhD research. I wish you to defend your PhD research and become to get the doctorate status. And yes, thank you, Mawulawoe, for today's conversation.
Thank you so much, Mariana, for also inviting me. I wish all the women out there who are in the art space to keep on doing whatever they are doing, because they are also empowering the younger generation of women that are in the agricultural space, whether they are into farming or they are into the study of agriculture. So I really am happy for this opportunity to share my life. For me, it's all about diversity and inclusion in this conversation. And I'm happy to be able to have this conversation with you way in Ghana, out here, and just being able to spend time to share my life with you and my story with you. So I really appreciate this time. Thank you so much for everything.
Yes, thank you, and have a nice day.